Rod, if you can, some heartbreaking, devastating news that came out yesterday about a break and enter into the Legion. Can you tell us just a bit more about it, sir?
Well, we had a great weekend, so of course we were pretty happy about that until we come in on Sunday morning to find out some people had broken in here. Their intent was to come in to find our safe. We called the police right away. They come in and they had a crime scene investigator here, and they've all come to the conclusion that the perpetrators came through the front door, broke into the bar room, into the club room, into the Legion office, and somehow took our two big, heavy safes out of here.
For those that haven't seen the safes, and I would think not too many people have, can you describe them? And like we were talking about earlier, just talk about how heavy these things are. This wasn't easy.
No, it wasn't. The safes were very old. They came from our old Legion across the street. There were two of them. They were probably 2 feet by 2 feet by 2 feet square. The walls on them were extremely thick, probably 3 inches. How they were able to pick it up, I don't know. They either had a mechanism in here of some sorts, or two or three very, very strong guys to pick them up. Got them onto the floor, untied their cart or the pool table cover, and drug them out of here, and they were gone long before we came here.
It couldn't come at a worse time?
No, couldn't come at a worse time at all. We're struggling a little bit. We're getting back on our feet from a slow summer. We have a lot of overhead here, so consequently, with a lot of activities going on during the summer, it puts us behind the eight ball a little bit. But, you know, it was a great weekend. We had several events over in the banquet hall that hauled in a lot of money. We had both bars in operation. We had our meat draw for the turkey and hams for Thanksgiving on Friday and Saturday. So it was one of our best weekends in a long time. And it was very heartbreaking to come in for two things, to find out that, you know, we'd lost everything we had just made. And not only that, but who comes into a Legion and steals for the veterans? The money's not ours, the money's the veterans. It's us to support the veterans. So it's very sad.
It's one of those things, and investigation's still ongoing, and I'm sure police are looking into it very seriously. But the people that did it could have been here.
Could have. I'm pretty sure that, I mean, I don't know for sure, but I feel that whoever did this was in here casing the place, whether it was for a week or a month or whatever. But, you know, they're aware of the fact that we didn't have any cameras. They're aware of the fact that they probably saw money moving around in the club room and just cased it out and decided the good time to come in would be in the middle of the night when nobody was here. And we're on the back side of the condo, so condo people coming and going, if they're around, we're on the south side of the building, we're on the north side. We're on a very dead street at night.
Legion's been around for how long, if you know, I'm catching you off guard with this one, but Legion's been around for how long in something like this? You just, it's a tragic way how things have changed.
Well, the Legion itself's been around for nearly 100 years, if not more, since the First World War. You know, the Legions were going great for years and years, and then all of a sudden there was a downturn, and we lost membership, branches were closing due to activities and support and community involvement. But lately, the Legion's been growing extremely well. There are still some branches that are suffering. Our branch is the fastest growing Legion in the entire country. We have nearly 1,000 members now, which has grown several hundred since we opened the new branch. But we still need our members to come out and, you know, participate in activities and whatnot to help us keep moving forward and keep our branch available to take care of the veterans and families.
Where do you go from here?
Well, right now we're waiting to hear back from the insurance company, but we suffered some substantial losses here, so we're putting a plea out to the community to perhaps help by doing some donations. We're going to put something out on our Facebook page and on our website, and also put a pitch in there if people would like to donate to help us get back on our feet again, take care of some of our commitments that we've been able to deal with at the moment, to pop by and do donations. So we're hoping people will come by between 2 and 6 in the next several days and see what we can do.
I was going to say, so if you can, how can they donate? where can they donate, and what would you like in terms of donation, like cash, or like what would you like?
Well, for now anyway, we're going to have some of our executive members in here every day between the hours of 2 o'clock and 6 o'clock, and if people want to donate, just to come in and give us a check. We don't have anything set up right now for e-transfers or anything, and we prefer not to have cash. Check right, made out to the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 133, and not to the Poppy Fund. When it goes into the Poppy Fund, that's for the veterans. We're doing our Poppy drive pretty soon, leading up to Remembrance Day. This is for the branch itself to help us recoup our losses and damages and get back on our feet.
Last question: How did it make you feel? How did it make the people feel of this Legion that give their sweat every?
Extremely upset, and a lot of people are afraid that, you know, something like this is to happen to the Legion. You know, what's going on? Our bartenders are nervous to leave on their own at night. It's pretty scary. We've got a lot of upset people, really upset. It's to steal from the Legion is ridiculous. You know, it's, you know, people going around and steal puppy boxes, for example. It's despicable to break in here and to take basically everything that we had at the time. We couldn't get to the bank until Monday morning to make any deposits. It was a safe place. Unfortunately, they took our safes.